and explore the Cawthron Aquaculture Park and find out how aquaculture can help agriculture. Rob's brought us out to the Cawthron Aquaculture Park here in Nelson, and we've got a bathtub here with some red floaty things. What's going on, Rob?
Hi there, Shelley. So here at Cawthron, what we're growing here are the Asparagopsis, which is one of those types of red seaweed we saw down in Kaikoura. And we have the sporophyte phase here, these little pom-poms. This is what all the seaweed grows from for this species.
All right, so you say the sporophyte phase. Does that mean it produces spores? This is what you're going to grow more red seaweed from?
Exactly. So this is one of those sexual phases of the seaweed. And it's how it grows and moves around before it settles out and becomes a bigger plant.
Right. So why are you particularly interested in this species?
So this species has a special chemical in it called bromoform. And what happens with that is when you feed it to cattle and other animals, it reduces the amount of methane in their burps.
Wow. So why do you want to reduce the amount of methane?
So methane is one of the emissions that has a really big impact on our climate. So if we can reduce the amount of methane that comes from our cattle, because we have a lot of cows here in New Zealand, that'll dramatically reduce our effect on the environment.
Right, I'm just thinking, there are a lot of cows in Aotearoa. How on earth are you going to produce enough of this species to feed them?
Well, that's where our scientists here at Cawthron come in. So all of the pom-poms we've got here, these were grown from 4 2-millimetre pieces of wild seaweed. So they've done a really good job figuring out all the conditions and environments that the seaweed needs to grow from those four pieces into this bathtub full of sporophytes.
Sounds like a miracle, really, being able to grow from that little a piece. So when you're talking about feeding it to cows, is it going to be the only thing that they eat?
No, the seaweed would make up a very small part of their diet. It's about 1%, which is about 100 grams a day for a cow.
Wow, which is not very much. So the idea is that you're going to farm this in the future to try and reduce the amount of methane in cows. Sounds incredible.
Yeah, exactly. And there's lots of different ways we could farm it. So one example we've got in front of us here, so we could do it on land-based facilities. We could also seed it onto lines and farm it in the ocean as well.
Yeah, which must be a lot better than trying to harvest enough from the wild. A lot of challenges in trying to get enough though.
Exactly, and that's why our team's working really hard to try and figure out all those little environmental parameters and the chemistry and the water flow to make sure we can grow enough of the seaweed.
Wow, it's pretty exciting work. Thanks for introducing us to that, Rob.
Thanks, Shelley.